said they've been out. Well, you guys ever been out on slope today?
We didn't go too far out. Okay. It's going to be too windy.
Yeah, don't let you over?
No.
The bottom fishing.
Yeah, gotcha.
Well, quick rundown on what we're going to be doing here today. We've got these 2 hour rippers. When we do get out, we'll have the 2 hour rippers out to the side. They're ready to release them. What I'll do is I'll run that line from the opposite distance and up to the end of those 2 hour rippers to get the nice wide spread. When something does, it'll snap free from that out ripper, pull back, and we'll bite on the rod and reel. Secondly, I will have over this corner, I'll have a deep troll or a down rigger. It's like a 12 pound lead ball with a release pin on the rod spinner. Allows us to troll down below the surface. Normally, I'll run one up top as well with the other. It's our shotgun line, and also one straight short off the back with the flat one. Basically, one thing y'all have to decide before we get out there is who's going to be first. Whenever we do get out there, one thing we don't want to have happen is to fish on and have you guys go, no, please, you go ahead. No, please. Get the chair down. When we do get a fish on, we're going to make a way to one of these bunch of chairs. Whatever side it strikes on, usually whichever chair you want to go to. When you hear a fish on, you're going to get seated down in the chair, and right there in between your legs is the gimbal mount right there. That's where the front of the rod goes, right in the gimbal. Immediately when you get that fish on, in your hand, immediately go ahead and get a couple breaths to start with, no matter what. A lot of times that fish is going to be taking line away from you. More often than not, it's going to be taking line away from you. Just all you got to do is basically try and keep the rod upright, all the ball's floating. When he does stop, you want to immediately start grading. What they like to do is they run, depending on how big a fish, a football field or two away sometimes. And when they stop, they do a crazy head shake. You want to make sure you're nice and tight to them. So if they stop, don't get the ugly game in the back. To get the maximum leverage out of your rod reel combo today, also you're going to do what's called bumping and winding. Of course, whenever you can just gain line, just crank it, just gain line. Set my loop guard up. When it does feel like you're at that standstill where you're not gaining by cranking anymore, you got to do what's called bumping and winding. That's where you slowly pull back on the rod, nice and smooth, no jerky stuff. You got to be nice and smooth on the pull back, crank, with the lowering. Okay, as simple as that. I'll be here to remind you as we go as well while we're doing it. But if you don't ever want to keep a nice fit in the rod, the whole fight will fit. But while you're cranking down, got to crank down fast and slow to pull back. Easy as that. If you do start getting your fish up here next to the boat, if it's catching or loose fish, I ask that we all kind of help each other out with the gimbal. So if it's easy to communicate, a picture of it no matter what happens. If one of your catching or loose fish is rules, like either touch or catch, so a lot of times, don't make it into the boat.
Yeah.
Well, y'all enjoy the ride. Yeah, feel free to ride.
Yeah.